Hey guys, what's going on? So what you're watching here is a clipped video from a whole video that you'll be able to access if you become a member on Patreon or if you become a member on my YouTube channel. These videos are relatively difficult to make because I'm using multiple sources to compile all the information together. And so with your contribution, I'll be able to make more content as well as create exclusive content for those of you who are really invested into this channel, who really want to understand a lot of advanced physics and life sciences. So with that being said, make sure to hit the like and subscribe button. Make sure to go onto the Patreon page and you can contribute there. You can also become a member here on YouTube. So let's now get into the topic. Hey guys, what's going on? So today we are talking about the moment generator function. Here is where we're really going to start tying things together in with probability and quantum field theory. We're going to keep on going with ideas in advanced probability theory, and we're going to just keep on going with that. But here's where we're really going to start tying in concepts from advanced physics, okay? And so with that being said, make sure to hit the like and subscribe button. Make sure to go into my Patreon channel if you want to support, or become a member here on YouTube if you want to support. Again, I've explained this before. The idea is to make this a business idea, right? This is to get with the aim of getting advanced science out to the general public so that you guys can know all of this at really what's a very minimal price. In order to learn this kind of stuff, you typically have to go to like a university and pay a buttload of money to do that. But here, I'm not requiring much of you. I'm just making these videos, having fun with it, and not require, like, again, this is $50 if at the most, right? So anyways, I diverge. Let's get into the moment generator function. So the moment generator function is super, super interesting. Let's see if I can move this up a little bit. The reason it's super interesting is because it's going to provide us something of a tool to understand partition functions in quantum field theory and even in statistical mechanics. And that's where we're going to get into statistical fields, right? So let's start. In probability theory, we're often interested in things called moments. A moment of a distribution is the part of the distribution that changes under translation of the random variable, whereas the cumulants of a distribution are the things that stay the same. So where we already have this lingo of invariant things and things that are not invariant, and this is going to be we're starting to talk about this is a little bit of language of physics, like invariant under some sort of translation or some sort of rotation or something like that, right? So, okay, we're bringing in the physics lingo here. In this video, we're going to cover the notion of the moment. And in subsequent videos, we're going to cover the notion of cumulants. These are going to be super, super important in understanding transformations of statistical fields. The kth moment of a random variable is this guy right here. Now let's make sense of this. The kth moment. We've sort of talked about this a little bit before. So the idea here is suppose we don't have a k right here. Suppose this is just x times our probability distribution function. And so if this was just x, this is our probability distribution function, this would be like an expectation value. This would be like an average energy or something like that. And we've talked about that. We've talked about the formula for the average energy before. It's the label that you're attaching to whatever times the probability distribution, okay? And we're summing over all of it. Okay, so if k was 1, this thing would be an average. This would be the mean of our probability distribution. So, and f, again, is the probability density function. Okay. Density is the distribution of mass. There's a lot of these terms are going to be interchangeable. We can make sense of this equation intuitively. The density is the amount of mass packed into some volume. The moment tells us the distribution of mass within that volume. We can generalize this equation. So when we generalize, we add this C. And this tells us, you know, okay, we've shifted away from an absolute origin. Right? So, and the shift is encoded through this constant C. Okay? Everything stays the same, right? So we're just shifting from our origin. Okay? And this enables us to understand the distribution relative to its mean and not the center of some Cartesian coordinate system. About the mean, we specifically would write this, where C becomes mu x, right? X doesn't, it's just a label for our x-axis, really. But this is just the value, the difference between the value and where the mean is. Okay? We're going to call this... we call this MK, and we can standardize this MK by dividing it by our standard deviation. So when you, this is usually how you standardize something. You divide it by its standard deviation, and that's really what standardization is, right? So you take, so with standardizing, we're going to put a bar on this guy. This is the standard, this is the standardized mean, okay, and the standardized mean looks like this, where we're dividing by sigma, and sigma again